So breaking news here out of California. I find this absolutely fascinating. And although I realize most of our lines are full here, people who wanted to talk to Congressman Pocan, he's gone. I'm here. And, you know, so, you know, if you have a call for him, call back maybe next week or the week after, the next time he shows up. But if you want to hang on and talk to me, that's fine. But I wanted to change topics somewhat, and that is about California. There is an independence movement, a secession movement in California that is starting to really gain some serious momentum. And this is rather shocking. This is a piece out of the, this is, let's see, Bay Area Storm Live Updates. This must be the San Francisco Chronicle. The author of the article is Marcus Ruiz Evans. Anyhow, Hillary Clinton won. This is what Marcus Ruiz Evans writes. Hillary Clinton won more than 61% of the popular vote in the November election. In a few weeks, the state of California will give Yes California, that's the name of the group, Yes California, the right to begin circulating petitions to qualify a Calexit vote for the 2018 ballot, as in California exit, like Brexit is British exit. Almost 7,000 volunteers will collect signatures for the petition. They go on to say, three reasons make this a very good idea. Number one, size. California is the sixth largest economy in the world. We can govern ourselves. Number two, taxes. California is a maker state, contributing more to the federal government than we receive. In contrast, South Carolina takes in more than $7 in federal funds for every $1 they contribute. And number three, culture. California is more liberal, more educated, and wealthier than most every other state. Our views on education, science, immigration, taxation, and healthcare are different. The author goes on to say, no one's going to pull money out of California if it secedes. No one's going to invade. No one's going to stop trading. There's just too much money invested here. Too many deals already going on. The world will not let the California economy be disrupted. And in another article out of Yahoo News, this by Sharon Bernstein, more Californians dreaming of a country without Trump. One in three California residents supports the most populous states, U.S. states, peaceful withdrawal from the Union, according to a new Reuters Ipsos opinion poll. 32%. Now, in 2014, just, what, 2.5 years ago, it was 20%. It's now 32% of Californians say, yeah, we should become our own country. The national average, by the way, favoring secession for whatever state you may happen to live in is around 20%. And that's down from 24% in 2014. But California in particular is really interesting. 39 million residents, the sixth largest economy in the world. It's already functionally a nation state. California was the first state to do serious emission controls, the catalytic converters, because of the smog in Los Angeles. And so car manufacturers all across the United States just started putting catalytic converters in cars. I mean, this was before there was a federal requirement because they wanted to sell into California. California can lead in so many areas, and it's one of the reasons why I think it's so important that they not separate from the Union, from the United States, because California could actually become the tail that wags the dog of the United States. California could become the center of resistance against an era of Trump. There is so much potential there. California, by the way, Yes California, the group that is pushing for the Cal exit, their email list jumped from fewer than 2,500 people. This was a fringe group before the election of Donald Trump, to 115,000 right now, according to the president, Louis Marinelli. That's pretty astonishing. I mean, that's very astonishing. And they're going to have 7,000 people out there. So, you know, I'd rather not, frankly, see California pull out of the United States and go their own way. I get it why somebody living in California might want to see that. But I'm one of these stay and fight guys. Very good friend of mine, in fact, right now is literally today on a plane with his wife to a little town in Mexico where there's a large American expat community to look at buying a house. One of my best friends, and a guy who goes back to the '60s as an organizer. I mean, he's just like, I'm out of here. You know, I'm old. I want to retire. I don't want to deal with this. I get that. You know, not so much the I'm old part, but I get the some people are like, damn, Turns out, apparently, according to an article, I think this was on the Huffington Post this morning, Peter Thiel, the billionaire who brought down Gawker, you know, by funding the Hulk Hogan's lawsuit against them, and who is a major donor to the, or a major participant in the Trump campaign and in the transition and everything else, this, you know, Silicon Valley libertarian billionaire, according to this article, is actually a citizen of New Zealand. He's apparently has dual citizenship, New Zealand and U.S., and, you know, has land, has property in New Zealand. It's like his backup country, right? Well, you know, I'm not a big fan of backup countries, and I've lived overseas. Louise and I and our kids lived in Germany for a year back in the 80s, and you get it that, you know, cultures are different. And I, frankly, love the culture in the United States. I'm not all that fond of, you know, the kind of so-called redneck culture, the Confederate culture, as it were. But it's part of my country. And you know, I want to reach out to everybody and wake people up and be part of taking this country back rather than watching California go independent. So, you know, we'll see how this comes out. Colin, in North Hollywood, California, you wanted to speak to this issue of California independence?
Yeah, Tom, great show. Wanted to give you a little bit of background. I was involved with a similar CalExit campaign about 10 years ago under George Bush, and we were ridiculed like such a fringe joke. And all of a sudden, the day after the election, it's like this thing just hit the ground running. Mm-hmm. And I mean,
you're talking the election of 2000? Of 2016. Okay.
This thing made a big comeback, and we all know Trump may not even realize what a pawn he is of Putin's. So what do you think about, and just one more thing, I don't think I heard you mention, the guy that's behind this big Yes California campaign, which used to be called Sovereign California, but nobody could spell Sovereign. he's actually got an embassy in Moscow already, and the guy lives in Siberia. So do you think part of this CalExit campaign just hitting the ground running the day after Trump got elected could be some kind of Russian psyop to destabilize or undermine the country?
Well, if you're reading the same article I am, and I've only got a couple of articles on this topic, apparently the guy had a Russian wife, and maybe it was a mail-order bride kind of thing, and was having a problem getting a visa for her to come into the United States. And that appears to be his connection to Russia. You know, whether this is, you know, more evidence or some evidence of you know, Russians messing with the United States or not, I have no idea. But I seriously, you know, whether he has those motives or not, I'm curious about Californians and, you know, what they think about it. So, Colin, thanks for the call. You know, time will tell. Time will tell. This is why, you know, there really should be a bipartisan commission looking into all of this stuff, you know, particularly if there was any involvement by Russians in our election and you know, just messing in the United States.